Good morning, ladies. Thank you for joining us in Far Above Rubies today. I'm so very glad that each of you are here. If you're just tuning in with us for the month, I hope that you'll go back and listen to the January 1st devotional because it's got some context for the book of Romans that's really going to help you as we continue to dig in, okay? Today we are talking about Romans chapter 5 verses 12 through 21, and we're going to speak for a few minutes on abundant grace. Verse 20 says this, "But as people sinned more and more, God's wonderful grace did much more abound, okay? As Christians, especially as Christians who may have been in church, may have had a relationship with God for a long time, maybe even most or all of our lifetime, we can start to look at the world around us and its sinful nature, and we can start to wonder if God can really redeem the prostitute or the drug head or the gangster or the drunk or the wife beater. God, we can start to wonder, we can start to question the grace of God and its power. We can start to look at those who don't look like us, who don't act like us as Christians, who don't have their lives as put together as some of us do, and begin to wonder, can God really redeem them? Can God really transform their life? And it's because we don't remember this scripture, that where sin abounds, grace does much more abound. The original language actually says the grace overabounds where sin is found out, okay? Where sin is found, grace does overabound, or there's too much grace. Can you imagine? There's too much grace. There's so much grace flowing out of the throne of God that there's actually too much. There's more than we could possibly need, more than the prostitute could possibly need, more than the drunk could possibly need, more than the drug head or the drug dealer could possibly need. There is more grace than the gang member could possibly need. More grace, where sin breeds, where sin multiplies, where sin reproduces like bunny rabbits, grace is overabounding. Grace has got it covered, okay? Grace has got it covered. I live in Sin City. I live in Las Vegas, and if you know anything about Las Vegas, it's called Sin City for a reason. There is sin upon sin upon sin. There is anything you could possibly imagine in the worst devious heart and mind out there available at your fingertips in Las Vegas, all right? But the hope that we have, the hope that we bring to this valley is that where that sin is, where that abundance of sin is, there is an overabundance or too much grace floating around for each and every soul out there. The reality is that God is sitting up in heaven. God is even sitting among us, and he's like Oprah Winfrey, all right? Oprah, everybody knows Oprah's Favorite Things show where she goes, and you get one, and you get one, and you get one, and she's doling out prizes left and right. Well, God's up there going, well, you get grace, and you get grace, and you get grace, and you get grace, and he's saying there's more than enough to go around. There's no sin you've committed. There's no brokenness inside you that God's grace does not cover for your life, okay? This is a simple thought, a short thought today, but I hope it blesses you, and I hope it helps you to look at the lives of those around you through a different light and realize that there is more than enough grace. There is too much grace, more grace than there is sin, and more grace than there are sinners in the world around you. Extend that grace, be a vessel for that grace, let God's grace flow freely through you. Go and read Romans chapter 5 verses 12 through 21, and if no one has told you lately, you are loved, and you are cherished, and you are valuable. And so is that person walking down the street from you, that prostitute, that sinner, that gang member, that drunk, that wife beater, that drug dealer, that there's enough grace for them because they are valuable too. You have beautiful, tremendous worth, my friend, and that worth is far above rubies. Thank you for being here with us today. You have two wonderful guest speakers coming to you the next 2 days. Make sure you tune in, let them know that you're here and you appreciate their time. I hope you'll go and find some friends to invite to this group as we grow daily in the Word. I will see you all again on Sunday. God bless you.